They're offering 100% of the money lost, but...
Simplii Financial customer Evan Cosner got the bad news on the same device he uses for his banking.
We got this notification yesterday saying that hackers have potentially taken over your account, and it could be cause for concern.
Already, the hackers' handiwork is showing up online. CBC News found a list of 100 names, BMO customers, their bank account, debit cards, social insurance numbers, home address, occupation, marital status, even their air miles number, out there for all to see and anyone to use. In an extraordinary twist, the hackers revealed how they got the information. In an email, the hackers say they used an algorithm to get account numbers, then they posed as authentic customers who had forgotten their password. That, they say, allowed them to reset the backup security questions and answers, giving them access to the account. Some experts say banks aren't doing nearly enough to protect customer information.
There's things that they can do. Such as simple items as encrypting the data that you hold on your servers, that even in the event of an accident or a malicious act, that data is not going to be useful for anybody that gets access to it.
When they do get access, in most provinces, there are no rules forcing companies to notify consumers of a security breach.
We have no idea of the size of the problem, how many companies are having trouble with this, and how many records of people's personal information are lost every year.
Too many for Evan Cosner.
Well, you're remarkably calm given that all of this is going on.
Again, I've been through it 3 times this year.
That's right. He was also caught up in hacks at Home Depot and Nissan. Now he can add his bank to the list. Aaron Saltzman, CBC News, Toronto.
Security experts often give us the same and important advice. Monitor your account activity. Consider paying for one of those services that will notify you when someone applies for credit under your name. Have unique passwords for different accounts and change them often. Why? Well, here's what hackers can do with your personal information. The kind of data the hackers say they have stolen is valuable in 2 ways. First of all, it is financial data. It can be used to buy goods online like electronics, which are then resold. Even more anonymous, criminals can buy gift cards, and then in turn, it can be used to buy resellable goods. But it gets worse. This is the kind of sensitive personal information that can be used to take over a person's identity. So having your name, your date of birth, your social insurance number allows criminals to apply for bank accounts, credit cards, but also to rent rooms, get cars, equipment, all in your name. Because many of us tend to reuse or only slightly vary our passwords, knowing a password for one account can help a hacker get to or at least guess others. The data in this breach can also help craft convincing emails that can prompt you to click and download malware. That's called spear phishing. If they get a hold of email or social media accounts, they can then use that tactic on your contact lists and leapfrog to your friends, other victims, and then on to even more. But these hackers seem to want their cash fast, and this may not be the only scam they've got going. They want the ransom paid to this digital wallet in the cryptocurrency known as Ripple. It's been active for weeks and there's already millions of US dollars worth in there. If you are a BMO or Simplii customer, you're probably wondering whether you're affected, and in particular, if you're on that list of 100 names that Aaron mentioned. Both banks say they have been personally contacting affected customers and that they'll fully reimburse any losses. BMO telling the CBC in a statement that it has blocked online and mobile access to affected accounts. So if your card stops working, call the bank. Free credit monitoring services are also being offered.